Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2218, Power Map from Two Data Sets. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Well, I usually do these Power Excel seminars, and I always show a couple of Power Map examples, but I actually had someone in the audience the other day in Melbourne, Florida, who's been trying to use Power Map and had a question for me that I wasn't really sure of. How do you get two different layers, two different data sets on a map? And here's the way I found to do it. I'll be interested in the YouTube comments to see if someone has a better way. So I have these two different data sets. One by state and one by city. And so I want to create a filled map from this and a column chart from this. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to make both of them into a table with Control T. Table 1, horrible name. Let's call this states. And then Control T. And rename this as city. Now, what I have to do is I have to, before I start Power Map, I have to get both of these into the data model. If I'm lucky enough to have the Power Pivot tab, well, then that'll be really easy. Just click Add to Data Model, Add to Data Model. Well, let's say you don't have this tab. Okay, so here's my cheap and dirty way to do this. Insert, Pivot Table, add this data to the data model. And that just creates some sort of a pivot table, and I don't care, I just need to get the data into the data model. Then come over here, same thing, insert, pivot table, add this data to the data model. I'll actually put this one on the same worksheet that no one will ever see. I'll hide this worksheet or something like that. Click OK, and again, just some sort of data there, like that. Beautiful. All right, now that I have both of those in the data model, when I go to insert, Power Map or 3D Map, success. What I have now is both categories. So I'll build the city first, city and state like this. And we'll say the color is going to be the category, and then the score is going to be the height. All right, so there's our first map. And then I'm going to say add a layer. And for layer two, I'll use state. And this will be a filled area map. And our score will be the value, score, and the score will be the value. All right, so we get the different shapes there. Now that really, that is the ugliest color I've ever seen. So let's see if we can find some way to change that color that's down here under layer options. Instead of being based on a purple, I'll just go with some other color like that. Maybe something darker so I can see the changes. All right, so Florida has the highest score. Louisiana has the lowest score. All right. Oh, and I missed Alabama completely. All right, so that's it. The whole trick to this is to get both data sets into the data model. And again, if you have the Power Pivot tab, that's easy. Just choose one data set, add the data model, choose the other data set, add the data model. But if you don't, then in Excel 2013 or 16, insert pivot table, add this data to the data model would work. Or heck, even Power Query, data from a table, and then close and load to add this data to the data model. So lots of different ways to get both tables in there. But if you don't put both tables in the data model before you head to Power Map, well, it's just never going to work. Yeah, my new book, Mr. Excel Live, the 54 Greatest Excel Tips of All Time, includes some Power Map examples. Check that out. Click the eye in the top right-hand corner for information about that. Wrap up of today's episode, how can you build a Power Map with two different data sets? You have to get both tables into the data model, and you can do that one of three ways, either with Power Query, Power Pivot, or just create a pivot table and choose that box that says add this data to the data model. Do that for both tables. And then when you launch Power Map, you can build the first map and then click Add Layer and use the other data set. To download the workbook from today's video, visit the URL in the YouTube description. I want to thank you for stopping by. I'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.